Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I have something exciting, which is this Konica Auto Date. So basically this is also one of the first few autofocus camera by Konica. It was launched back in the early 1980s, right after the Konica C35AF. So this was like a few years after that. And it comes with this like lens cap, which is like detachable. So over here we got the flash, the viewfinder, as well as the ISO ring here. So basically you want to adjust your ISO, you just move this ring. So then here will be the flash function, which is like similar to the Konica C35AF. Over here we have the battery. So this camera is powered by 2 AA batteries. So yep, as you can see inside, it's pretty clean. Over here at the back we have this data bag. Yep, and there's a battery, and then over here there is actually like a small program for it. So you can choose your like your date and time options, the year and the month and the date. So after than that, you open up. Over here you get the where you put your film inside. Then you drag all the way to here. So yep, this is a data bag behind it. And then for the like this camera has like rewind function. So basically the rewind button is up here. Yes, which I don't really like it, because sometimes you accidentally like on your camera, and then you accidentally like switch to rewind, so it like mess up your film inside. So there will be this latch here. You can see here is where you actually play with the camera. So normally I will put it off when it's not in use. And then yep, this is a C35AF. So basically you need to load in the film first before you turn on the camera. Yes, if you turn on the camera and you start pressing, they can hear the motor trying to rewind and like trying to like wind up the film. So it's trying to do like indication that there is no film inside, and it quickly tell you like the camera is hungry for film, please put it inside. Yes, so other than that, I'll put in the batteries and the film inside first, and I'll show you the next step. Yep, so basically I got this Konica Centria 200. So once you put the film in, you drag all the way into here, then you just like press to make sure that everything is tight, then you just close the flap behind here. Alright, then the next step is you turn on the camera. So once you turn on the camera, you will hear some whining sound. So the whining sound is indicate that the film is at 1. So after that, it just, it's simple because this is actually MFD, is actually like a motor drive function. So you just press and then the camera goes. Yep. One more time, I show it to you how it works. Yep. So currently my flash is spoiled, so yep, things cannot work there unfortunately. So just like, I try to on, hope that, because this is a pop-up flash, and then the flash will, the button here will charge up to become like orange, then you press, the flash will work. And by the way, there's one cool feature I want to show you about this camera, which is called the self timer. So basically the self timer is over here. Yes, over here there's a lever. All you do is you push it down. Yep, so this is the self timer. All you do is you just press this shutter and the timer will go off. Yep, it sounds like a car reversing. So let's hear it again. Yep, that's how it worked. Yes, so sorry I paused the video because I got something on. Yep, and here is actually the rewind function. So basically, so once you're done, right, always remember to like rewind back your film. So I'm not too sure whether this is auto rewind or not, so we will check it out at the end of the video, like towards the end, because I already pressed to 30 ready shots. So basically, this is the camera. It's quite good. I would say it's quite heavy, like quite strong, quite sturdy. Like it's good for like a beginner user to use. So now let's play the film 2 36. By the way, there's some function here. It's actually called a focus lock function. So yep. So basically, you just lock the focus. Yeah, something like you just like lock a focus. So by the way, right, I just found a cool feature is that when you actually half press, you will actually see I don't think you can see, yes, actually you can see like a red dot. Yes, so it's trying to say that it is actually trying to focus in the viewfinder. So yes. Sorry, because the battery is running a bit low already. Okay. So once you're at 36 here already, yep, it refused to move. So you have to manually set it to rewind. So how? It just move all the way to rewind. Then you just press. Then you just like go back all the way to rewind. Sorry, the lever wasn't all the way. So once you go back to rewind, it just start like rewinding back your film all the way to the end. It's quite noisy actually. And just put off. Yep, so there you go. Magic, everything works. Thanks guys for watching. Remember to share, like, and comment. If you got any more suggestions, feel free. I read through all your comments. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Take care.